Good afternoon. My name is Gennadeso Federico, representative of the Fellini Foundation for Europe and Asia. We are very happy to take part to this Calcutta Literary Festival, and we are going to talk today about one of the most important cinema maestro in Italy, Federico Fellini. 2020 was the centenary of Fellini. And the celebration of this maestro will go on also in 2021. So that's why we are here to present you how the Fellini Foundation was celebrating this important maestro. The Fellini Foundation was established in 2001, and till now, thanks to our 15,000 documents about cinema, 9,000 of which only about Federico Fellini, we organized more than 100 cinema events like exhibitions, presentations, and so on all over the world. We had important exhibitions in Louvre in Paris, in Eye Museum in Amsterdam, in Singapore at the Nanyang Technological University, in Jakarta at the Italian Institute of Culture, not forgetting also in Belgium at the European Economic and Social Committee, inside exactly the European institutions, and also in the United Nations building in Geneva. We had several interesting locations related also to films during the Italian Bangkok Film Festival and the Venice Film Festival in Palazzo Benzon, where we presented an exhibition about 8.5. After this long journey, we arrived in 2015 in Singapore, and we signed an agreement with Nanyang Technological University, and we brought the first exhibition of Fellini, Fellini Circus of Light, where we put together almost 50 pieces, 50 items of our collection, and we made a dialogue, an interdisciplinary dialogue, with some artworks produced by professors of that university. Then we organized a PhD on Fellini, and we are now organizing also another important tool called Fellini Wall. Fellini Wall is a new digital archive on Federico Fellini. We started this project and we presented it in Geneva during the exhibition we organized about Fellini and human rights. So the next video you are going to see, I brought you one of our three big exhibitions that we did in Sion, Switzerland for the 2020, Fellini Oniric Obsession. This exhibition shows important drawings coming from the most important Fellini collection, the Fellini collection of the Cinémathèque of Rimini, the one of Philippe Jakob Kehl, which is based in Zurich, and the one, our collection, based in Sion. It was the first time that the three collections were together for an event. It was very important for us to show one of the most mysterious movie of Fellini, The Voyage of Gima Storma, an unfinished movie. And through the exploration of the theme of Eros and Thanatos, we developed an interesting discussion on how drawings were important for Fellini, for the Fellini production, and also how these Oniric obsessions were part of the movies after The Voyage of Mastorna, the movie that Fellini did after this experience. In the videos that you are going to see soon, you will see an immersive exhibition in our cultural center in Sion, which is the place where we organize all the exhibitions that we presented in during this centenary in Switzerland. We had two other exhibitions, and one was dedicated to the artists who were dealing with Fellini, which is also another topic that it's quite important. The exhibition was called Anima, and we brought two important artists that were working with us in Switzerland for several months about Fellini. So let's see immediately some video contributions about the exhibition Oniric Obsession.
Jungiano Bernard dall'inizio degli anni 60 in cui, ecco, questo è un piccolo tour in alcune sale della mostra, ma arrivederci al Museo Internazionale Federico Fellini, che nascerà da dicembre 2020 all'interno della Rocca Malatestiana del Cinema Fulgor e del percorso che collegherà i due edifici. Arrivederci, a presto.
I hope you enjoyed the exhibition, Images of Fellini Lyric Obsession. Now we are going to talk about other activities that we had, the activities in Asia. As I told you, we arrived in Singapore, but then also in Jakarta. This year we did also two important exhibitions in Thailand during the Bangkok Italian Film Festival, organized with the Italian Embassy and several partners. During this festival, we brought our exhibition dedicated to Fellini and David Lynch, and the exhibition Fellini and the Human Rights. These two exhibitions were shown first in House Amian and the second one in Bach, which is a very important contemporary art center. After this trip to Thailand, we arrived in January at the Calcutta International Film Festival, where we brought an exhibition about photos, Fellini photos, Fellini at work. So we showed the maestro at work, we showed the maestro dealing with actors and actresses like Marcello Mastroianni, Anita Ekberg. So we showed to the Indian public a little bit the atmosphere of Dolce Vita that was typically part of that period. And this exhibition was also paired with a series of screening of movies of Fellini, and we were very surprised and happy about how well received this exhibition and retrospective, how well received it was by the Indian public. Right now, I'm going to show you something really innovative, what we did in Cannes. In France, Cannes is famous for the film festival, and we worked with the orchestra of Cannes Côte d'Azur to organize an incredible event. On one side, an exhibition about Fellini on the promenade, so on the place where normally people take a stroll along the water. And so they were able to see some photographs from our collection. And on the other side, in the evening, we organized a tribute to one of the most important friend, collaborator of Federico Fellini, Nino Rota. So there was a concert which was organized on Place Massé, which is a beach. Where normally also some screenings of the Cannes Film Festival are taking place. And so we were able to organize this important event just a few minutes before, let's say, the lockdown in France. So we were really lucky. But this formula is very interesting. So an open air exhibition, an open air exhibition that in this moment of COVID, it's quite important also to create innovative ways of showing artworks. And this is exactly what you are going to see in the next video. 100% open air event, which took place in Cannes, in the south of France. Enjoy the video.
Par plaisir et par devoir, mais surtout par plaisir, de rendre hommage à ce compositeur et surtout à la collaboration absolument unique qu'il a eue tout au long de sa carrière avec presque un unique compositeur, c'est-à-dire Nino Rota. On a une collaboration qui est très particulière parce qu'on ne sait pas, c'est toujours la question de l'œuf et de la poule, on ne sait pas ce qui crée. Lequel crée l'autre. J'ai l'impression que c'est grâce à la musique de Nino Rota que certains des films de Fellini peuvent rester dans la mémoire collective. Donc il y a une sorte de médium assez incroyable de cette musique de Nino Rota qui sert les films de Fellini.
So welcome back. I hope you enjoyed the video on the music of Nino Rota. And we are at the end of this video about Federico Fellini. I would like to thank again the organization of the Calcutta Literary Festival, and I hope that we are going to organize in the next future other events of Fellini, and the Fellini Foundation for Cinema will be always happy to collaborate with Calcutta and to create a cultural bridge between India and the Italian maestro. Thank you very much.